morning, good afternoon, good evening, fellow Biafrans. Wherever you're watching us this afternoon, I am sorry, my voice, I lost my voice. I will try as much as I can to speak up so that you can hear me very loud and clear. Wherever you're watching us from, I want you to share this program. We are coming to you live and direct as in the Hot Biafra TV on YouTube. We are live and direct there. Those of you that are watching us from that site should confirm if my voice is coming out loud and clear. We are live and direct on Biafra Television. We are also live and direct on IPOB Community Radio. We are live and direct on Radio Biafra and so many other platforms. This program that is coming to you this afternoon is coming as an emergency program. But I'm going to bring to you the full package program on Tuesday. But today, I want to water the ground. Thank you very much, Ike Ezora. Thank you for confirming that you can hear us loud and clear. Kindly share this program, share and share and share. Because I have lost my voice. I've been speaking so much. I've been doing a lot of consultations. I have been digging up a lot of facts and figures. I've been digging up a lot of informations and informative messages that you need to keep yourself ready and strong, to know where you belong, to know the truth, to know how you go and where you go to prepare your mind so that when the enemies come with their lies, when they have bought them over to begin to speak ill of the man that God has given to us to restore Biafra, when they begin to speak ill of IPOB in general, when they begin to speak ill of all the people that are fighting, all the genuine people that are fighting to restore this nation that we are all crying for, you will know when they are lying and when they are saying the truth. All this information that I've been digging up from one angle to another with facts and figures from true sources, I tell you, it's going to be a blowing mind information that when you listen to it, some of you are going to shed tears. Some of you are going to shed tears because today's program, like I said, is going to be I'm watering the ground against Tuesday, because Tuesday is the D-Day when I will pebble everything that you need to know about the idiot you call George Onyibe. I have warned him severally on my platform that I'm waiting for him to come out. I have spoken to him that if you come out the way you're coming out now, then when I expose you, you'll be left nothing but a chaff. In fact, a chaff is going to be more useful than George Onyibe. And it's starting today. I have learned how to speak to our people. I've learned how to give our people an important information. I've learned how to tell our people the truth the way they will understand it. Because sometimes when you give our people the truth raw, the way it is, without, you know, building a preamble, without giving them evidences, they find it very difficult to comprehend. They find it so difficult to understand. They find it so difficult to believe. Because in their mindset, some of them never believe that some people in this struggle can betray. So when such people betray us and begin to speak ill of us and begin to say all manner of nonsense, it will be very, very difficult for them to believe you when you are telling them the truth and how it have come. They won't believe it. Sometimes I don't blame these people. Sometimes I don't blame them because those that have sweet mouths in the struggle, those that sweet mouth talked everybody into believing in them, into thinking that they are the genuine people fighting for our freedom, not knowing that they are always money mongers in the struggle. So when you begin to tell them the evil that these people have perpetrated in the struggle, our people will not understand it. They will say it is a lie. How can this person do this? This person that has spoken against this, how can he be the person that will do it? But on this channel, as it is run, Biafra Television, I tell you that Mazo Pelletuku became my job is to begin to expose them, each and every one of them. The information that I am getting, you may not be privileged to get it. The information that I'm having, you may not be privileged to have it. So that is why it is very, very important that when I host my program, you listen and listen good. And before you can be able to understand my message that I'm passing through this channel, you have to zero your mind. You have to zero your mind. You must, if you don't zero your mind, then you will not understand my message. You have to neutralize your mind. You have to receive, you have to remove every emotion that have engulfed your sense of reasoning. Because when you attach emotion on the information that I am giving to you on this channel, you may not be able to concede it. You will say, no, this is too much. I can't believe it. Just like when I was hitting and giving you people signal about Uche Mefo. When Uche Mefo started telling the world that he was a razor, that he's going to court. When I started warning him, I said, Uche Mefo, be careful. Some of you were attacking me. Some of you doesn't understand what we are talking about. Until Uche Mefo came out in the open. Until Uche Mefo came and showed you people the stuff that he was made of. And some of you have now returned back to say, you are sorry for attacking President Darlington. You are sorry for attacking our people. You are sorry for defending the evil in Uche Mefo. Today, I know all of you that are using fake accounts coming to this channel to speak nonsense. And each time I dictate any one of you, I will block you. Once I block you, you can never come with that same fake account. You can create as 1 million as you want, but we are going to block them 2 million times. That is to show you that each of the fake accounts you created, when I block it, I'll be ready to block it again. That's how many times you created them. So my brothers and my sisters, forgive me if my voice is not coming clear the way you expect, because I must tell you that I've been talking much all these days. A lot of job have been done. If you don't hear from me, if you don't get any information from me, if you don't watch from my program, know you that I am not sleeping, that I am working on the ground to dig up all those information that you need. Like I always tell you, that their job is to sell in lies. Their job is to try to bring us down. Their job is to take money from the enemies, from the enemy's camp. Then they come back and lie against us. But my own job is to expose them with truth and nothing but the truth. To expose them with truth and nothing but the truth. Please permit me to sip hot water. Because of my throat, I need to sip some hot water, please. Yes. I want you to begin to share this program. Share this program extensively. Share it on your WhatsApp groups. Share it on your Facebook groups. Share it on your Facebook Messenger groups. Anywhere you are, I want you to share this program. The reason why you need to share this program, because as in the heart, that's how they bring and give you. This program is not going to exit 2 hours. No matter how sweet it is, no matter how bitter it is, no matter who is calling, no matter who is disturbing, I just want you to rest on 2 hours. Therefore, I'm going to use some minutes to speak to you. Then I'll open my line for calls. But I want you to know that this is a preparation full package of truths of the coming Tuesday program. When I would pieces George Onibe, I think they know how to play voice notes. They know how to play voice notes. When you are speaking with your brother in this struggle, they keep recording you. That is one thing that I have found so much funny in this struggle. That brother cannot trust his brother. Sister cannot trust his sister. You will be calling to speak to a principal officer. The principal officer is busy recording whatever you are discussing with them. And when they are done recording, they will edit. They will be in the same line with you. They will be saying the same thing that you are saying. They will be even saying more than you did say. But when it is time for them to edit, they will remove their own voice and play your own voice. This is the job of the lunatic, of the crony, the idiot you called George Onibe. And on this platform, I am going to reveal everything to you. I told the judge Onibe that as long as I'm consigned, that you once you come out in the open to show the color you are made of, then I will business you. I said it on my program. I will deal with Judge Onibe. Judge Onibe should go and ask Magnus Oraka what happened to him. Magnus Oraka was busy collecting money from our people. He was shouting. He was, you know, jumping up and down. He was doing all manner of nonsense, thinking that he's working for IPOB. People like us, we are watching him with one eye. Just like the one you call, the one that lives in America that called himself Clayton Udo. Clayton Udo was shouting, Biafra 101, Biafra 102, Biafra 103, Biafra 104, shouting. And I knew that people like him never last. I knew that people like that never last. I was watching them. Because in this struggle, like I said, we have two kind of people in this struggle. Those that make things to happen and those that want things to happen. Therefore, when they were shouting, if what they seek for, which is position number one, position number two, to be popular, number three, to make money, if they cannot get any one of these, they come against Mazina Nkanu, they come against IPOB, they come against the leadership, they come against everything that we have worked for. This is their plans. And best people like me, I knew them. I have thrown it as an open challenge on this platform. Judge Onibe, I'm mentioning you by name. I want you to come to host that your program where you are telling the whole world bunch of lies. What I, Major Pelese Chukwu, became president, have done against this struggle, or have done in this struggle that is not in line. Now, my brothers and my sisters, while you are listening to the sound of my voice, I want you to zero your mind. I want you to zero. If you don't zero your mind, you will not be able to conceive this information about I'm about to give to you this afternoon. If you attach sentiment, emotions, you will not be able to understand it. Because there is different between I hear and different between I see. I am the man who is on the ground. I am the man that runs the affair of IPOB in the palace of Ezu, in the palace of Eze Israel Okukalo. For the years that Mazina Nkanu spent in the palace, or the months that he spent in the palace, I am the man that runs the affair in that palace. I am not boasting about it. Our leader Mazina Nkanu is watching. He is watching this program live and direct, because I cannot lie, knowing fully well that the world knows the truth that I'm saying. So I am not speaking to you as somebody who is listening from far distance. I speak to you like somebody who is in the system, who knows the system. Judge Onibe, if a message is supposed to pass to Judge Onibe, I am the man that Mazina Nkanu will call. Most of the times, you say, let me say 70% or 80% of information that it was going to him. Prince Darlington called Judge Onibe telling this. Prince Darlington called Ikechukwu Ogwaha telling this. Prince Darlington called the coordinators on the ground in Biafra land. All of them knew that was the position I was placed. I have not spoken about it before. I have not said anything about it before. But I'm going to say it today so that you know the importance of every detail and information I'm going to give you today on this platform. I am not a coordinator. I have never been a coordinator. But I work directly under the office of Mazina Nkanu. I work directly under the office of Mazina Nkanu. I follow him. I go with him everywhere he went. I does all the things that I was supposed to do in the palace. I don't need to begin to mention them. But why I am telling you this is for you to know the man that is speaking to you right now, this afternoon. Some of you may be saying, who is this one now? That I'm not putting on suit, looking big or looking somehow to you, has nothing to do with the information I want to give to you. By the way, I am not a poor man. By the way, I am not a poor man. I repeat it again. Before this struggle, I have made money. Before this struggle, I have built my own house. Before this struggle, I have ridden my own car. Before this struggle, I have owned my own company, registered. I have evidence. I am not the man that show off. If not, by now you will see my house on Facebook. I will be posting, say, this is my house. This is this. I don't do that because it's not important. So what I'm trying to tell you this afternoon is this. George Onyibe is a man that I have his secret in my barn. George Onyibe is a man that I knows everything that he is doing in this struggle. Every report that is coming from the office of African Rep, every report that was coming from the office where George Onyibe operates as interim Nigeria coordinator is in the palm of Major Bale Chukwu Bikemeyachi Nyanaka. I have it in my hand. The reason why I have not spoken all this while is because of I'm doing a lot of consultation, and I must tell you the gospel truth that on Tuesday, this coming Tuesday, because when I'm done with George Onyibe, when I am done with George Onyibe, Biafrans, you will know that the devil you know is better than the angel you don't know. When they are with us, when they are handling positions, they will be praising Mazen Nandekani in the high esteem. They will be calling him names. Just like some people say that now that I'm calling Mazen Nandekani names, I'm praising him, blah, 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 that tomorrow I may change. I am not holding any position. I am not even interested in any position. I am happy and I am contented doing what I'm doing within my capacity, and I am recognized by Mazen Nandekani. So there is no room for maybe tomorrow, if they remove you from the position, there's no position at all. The position is that I am walking directly to his office. It is on record. You can go and check. So Mazonyibe's every detail, everything that happened about Mazonyibe, call him now, Buaka. It is in my palm, Mazonyibe, I know you are watching. And while you are watching, while you are cooking your lies, be ready to take my firewood. Because I'm going to put my firewood under that pot which you are using to cook the lies. And I will make sure that my firewood never finishes until the water you are using to cook that lies got dried up. Once it is dried up, then the lies will now turn to charcoal. Is going to get burnt, then we will turn to charcoal. Then when I bring it out, I'll grind it like this. I do it. It will fade into air. It will dismiss into the thin air. You are cooking lies, calling IPOB Yahoo, calling Mazen Nandekani Yahoo. You George Onyibe. You know how many times you come to the palace and you were locked outside. You know how many times you come to the palace when nobody knew who you were. You know how many times I gave order for you to come into the palace. Once I get information that you are outside, nobody knew you. Don't even you were a nobody in this struggle. Or did you go? When Tony Tiger was occupying the position, the seat that you occupied last, I know a lot of moves that you made. I know a lot of moves that you have made in Iguacha. I know how you want to restructure Iguacha to favor you, to your own favor. I have all these informations. I have all these facts and figures, but I kept them waiting. Knowing that someday something may happen, then I will come out, boom. Some of you may not understand what I'm saying. But by the time you begin to listen, I am not going to give you everything today because I'm not fully prepared for it. My leader, Mazen Nandekani, is coming to speak to us by 7. I need to run this program for only 2 hours. After 2 hours, I'll end the program. Then I will now use this opportunity to let you prepare your mind on Tuesday. As in the work, that's why they show. George Onyibe, all the info that you did against Tony Tiger, including when he was arrested, all the jobs, all the underground work you did, Jojonibe, I have it in my palm. When you were the African rep, interim Nigeria governor, coordinator, when you were in River State, whatever deputy that you were there making noise. You were shouting, calling Mazin Namdekanu. The radio was given to you. You were there showing yourself, bragging, you know, praising him. Today, the same people that you are praising, the same people that you have spoken very beautiful of, are the same people that you are calling Yahoo Yahoo. That means you are part of the Yahoo Yahoo people that you are calling today. And your own Yahoo Yahoo, I'm going to expose. All the people that have sent money to you, George Onibe, I am going to be exposing all the receipts of the money that you, George Onibe, have collected. All the people that have sent money to you, George Onibe, I'm using this platform to call on those that have not contacted me yet. Those that have not contacted me yet, begin to contact me now. Begin to feed me those receipts, all those money that all of you have sent to George Onibe. Money for transmitter, those that sent him a laptop, that on my own side, everything that IPOB members did for me, I used to say it here in the open. That is why I don't have a secret. That is why I'm not afraid of anything. That is why whatever that anybody wants to say about me is already in the open. In regards to this struggle, because I have not committed anything, I have not done anything. My hand is as clean as crystal. So you were there because they gave you radio station to be broadcasting. You have used us to do Yahoo Yahoo. So after using us to do Yahoo Yahoo, extorting money from our people, now you have turned against us. Now let me go into the business of the day, because I did not pray and I don't need to pray. I don't need to pray. Let me go straight to the point. George Onibe, every recorded voice that you have made in this struggle, that you are beginning to play one after the other now, I give you between now and Tuesday to play all of them to show the whole world. All those internal discussion that you have with your fellow principal officers that you are beginning to play out now, showing the world, I want you to continue between today. Today is Sunday, tomorrow is Monday, until Tuesday. Because after Tuesday, if you play it, it will be expired. After Tuesday, any voice note which you recorded as a traitor that you are, as a thief that you are, is expired after Tuesday. So it may be valid, because people would like to listen to it between now and Tuesday, because after Tuesday, nobody will listen to you again, because you are a pathological liar. George Onibe, you are a pathological liar. Devil is learning how to lie from you, George Onibe. Now, when you were arrested, I want to touch few things to build the foundation of what you people are going to hear. When you were arrested, George Onibe, 2 weeks to 3 weeks of your arrest. Let's say between 2 weeks to 3 weeks of your arrest. By then, our leader Mazin Namdekanu was still in Kuje prison. I was the man, the person that your wife contacted. Because every IPOB that visited Umahia knew that if you want to get to Oga, both coordinator and everybody, as long as our leader was on the ground, as long as he's concerned, must come through my office. That is to tell you that you joined the struggle when the struggle is already set. You were not with us in the struggle when we started the struggle from the scratch during the time of Ikechukwu Eniagu. You didn't know about Ikechukwu Eniagu and Ritani Bob. You didn't know what happened. You didn't know how we fight battle. We have fought a real battle, and we won all the battle. We fought against Bile Human Rights Initiative. We won them hands down. We fought with Clifford Chukwuemeke Iranya. We won them hands down. So I'm not fighting any battle with you. I'm just trying to expose you, because you don't have any battle. You have no battle. I am the person that your wife, I still have your wife number up to today. I am the person that your wife contacted, that your children are dying of hunger. Only 2 weeks of your arrest, 2 weeks, your children are dying of hunger. Your heart has expired. Biafra, listen attentively. You see how these people are doing. Once they get arrested, they use IPOB, they use the struggle to catapult themselves to millionaires. It seems like some of them are even praying for them to be arrested, so that out of the pity, they will begin to juke IPOB and begin to collect money from left, right, and center to feed their family. I am the man that your wife conducted. George Onibe, if I lie about what I'm saying today, let me not see Biafra. But if I'm saying the truth, you will not see Biafra. This is the swear. The highest swear I can swear in this life. Because I'm fighting to see Biafra, and I must see Biafra. Because I'm saying the truth. George Onibe, your wife contacted me, crying to me on the phone. Nagure Monum, okay? Nagure Mona family, okay? That your children are dying of hunger. Your house has been expired. You are nothing is happening again. That you in fact that since your husband and her husband was arrested, that they are finding it difficult to pay the school fees of the children. Only 2 weeks that you were arrested, though, your children's school fees expired, your house rent expired, your wife. These are the things that you concocted with your wife to tell me. And your wife told me. And out of pity, I made sure that I took your case very, very, very urgent. And I contacted the appropriate quarters. I contacted the appropriate quarters. And the first money that was sent to your wife, that money was 180,000 naira. Dear friends, I want you people to listen to this idiot, to this moron that is now ranting, shouting, calling IPOB Yahoo IPOB. The same IPOB that is Yahoo. The first money that was sent to your wife was 180,000. What I'm saying on this platform, if I lie, take away my life. But if it is truth, bless me and keep me safe from the eye of my enemy, and I will see Biafra. But George Onibe, you are not going to see Biafra. I have sworn again. The money was sent to your wife. Your wife collected the money, and she was happy. She did not call me again to say, my brother, thank you. I continue doing my work, just like other Biafras that are contacting me, telling me their problems. Then I'll channel it to where I'm supposed to channel it. 1 month. 1 month. Exactly 1 month. That is 2 weeks after you arrested. The 1 month that 180,000 was given to your wife. Your wife called me again. That the money that was sent to you people have finished. That there is a lot of problem. You use the money to do this. You use the money to do that. Blah, 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 blah. Your wife begin to cut a lot. Begin to cry to me on phone. She was crying on phone. What did I do again? I took the case upon myself. I forwarded it to the appropriate quarters once again. Therefore, I don't lie. Why am I going to lie? Why am I going to benefit from lying? I channel it to the appropriate quarters that the money that was sent to your wife is not enough for the feeding of the children and paying their school fees, that the house rent is still there, not yet paid. Why I'm saying all this is because when you hear them talk against IPOB, when you hear them talk against Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, when you hear them begin to sing like a canary, you'll be wondering, what were they ever, you know, treated good in this struggle? Have they ever benefited from this struggle? So Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is this wicked to them? This is what you'll be thinking about. But thank God that people like me, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is a very intelligent man. For him to keep me very close to himself, a lot of things that all of them, a lot of lies that all of them are saying, do that. It is somebody like me that will expose all of them one after the other. But the biggest lie and the biggest crime of this man is yet to be said, and you're going to hear them through this channel. George Onibe, the second one that was sent to your wife was 200,000. I facilitated for it. I called for it. This is why you are still in the prison. Dear friends, when they tell you that the IPOB that we arrested, they are forgetting them. They forget their family. The IPOB that have injury, they forget them. They don't do anything for them. The IPOB that are in the hospital, they forget them. They don't do anything. Prisca Chiamaka was the person in charge of IPOB's injured comrades. The welfare officer. As at this time, that all these things were happening. Prisca Chiamaka can testify to you how many millions that IPOB was busy spending on all our wounded comrades. And those that are in the prison, she is still alive. She can confirm what I'm talking about right now. In the issue of Mazwe Nyibe, the death money that was sent to Mazwe Nyibe's wife was 300,000. The first one was 180. The second one was 200. The third one was 300. That I know of, within the period of time that Onyibe was in the prison. So when they come out to tell you that IPOB have forgotten their own people, IPOB have not done this, Nandekan have abandoned people, my brother and my sister, do not listen to them. They are liars from pit of hell. They are liars from the pit of hell. John Onyibe, all the days that you spent in the prison, your family did not lack one naira. All the because when you are talking, you want to convince people, to make people to begin to have sympathy over you. Then you begin to lie that you went to the prison for IPOB, you did this, you did that, blah blah blah. You have occupied seven positions. Kiwan. Why you are occupying those positions? What have you been doing? What are the benefits that you are making from occupying those positions? That is why what I have come to expose on this platform. Your wife is not a member of IPOB. Your wife is not out there contributing to the IPOB. But because you are involved, money was sent to your family three times to my own knowledge. 180, 200, and 300K. Kuroko, therefore, I'm not saying I heard, I'm saying that I saw. I facilitated for it. Your family never lacked. Your children never stopped school. Your house rent was paid if it was expired for real. Your wife was enjoying. And the funniest part of it is that these people are very, very, very greedy people. Do you know that when Mazwe Nyibe's wife used to call me is whenever they need money. The first time she called me, they needed money. I facilitated for it. I made call to the appropriate headquarters. Money was sent to her. The money was not sent to me, to her. It was sent to her direct. Okay, bring her account. I will bring her account. I will call. Madam, did you confirm the money? She will say, yes, I confirmed the money. That's estate. For you to know how ungrateful these people can be. She won't call me to say, oh, my brother, thank you so much, Joe, at least for helping. Because then our leader was in the prison. There is no any way they would have gotten that help or gotten this person that can help them facilitate such, if not through me, knowing the office I was occupying before our leader, before all these things were happening. God will punish you and punish your generation. I want you guys to share this program because their lies have been too much. These guys have been lying, and I've been watching, I've been listening, I've been paying keen attention to all the lies that they have been saying against Mazin Nandekan, against this great man that never even sleep whenever he hears that someone is down or someone is sick or someone is arrested in this struggle. Mazin Nandekan cannot sleep. Never, ever, ever, ever. So, the wife will not call me again. No. She will never call me. Whenever I see, the next time I will see her call is to give me a complaint. Then I will do something again. Money will be sent to her. That ends the communication. That ends everything. No thank you. No dialogue. Or the wakwa, it will continue. She will see, once they blow that one again, finish it. But she will call me again for the third time. And I will do the same thing. And money will be sent to her. And it's because the husband is in the prison. And it's not, this is not happening only to only George Onyibe, including people like somebody like Brechin Ezie Ishunwa, who is The family appreciate. Chimezie appreciate. Chimezie's wife appreciate that IPOB never allowed them to go hungry. IPOB has never allowed Bright Chimezie's children to be starved for one day. Just as they did, just as our leader did to this ingrate called George Onyibe. Now, let me fast forward it a little bit for you guys to know that the man that is speaking is a man that is speaking from the side of the truth, not based on hearsay, but first-class information is first-class information. I'm not telling you this thing that somebody told me to say. I am telling you that I am in the front line. I saw it. It happened within my jurisdiction. It all happened within my jurisdiction. So when I'm talking, you know that I'm talking with fact and figures. That is why I am pleading for all those evil men and evil women who have left the struggle or who have been sacked from the struggle because of their malicious act, because of their treacherous act. Then they will form gang and begin to speak ill of the same struggle that have fed them for so many years, fed their family for so many years, took so many years, took care of them for so many years. George Onyibe, I want to remind you of something that you have forgotten. George Onyibe, all the transmitters that was handed over to you to take care of, the amount that is you are asked to disburse those transmitters to rural areas where people will be getting and hearing Radio Biafra. George Onyibe, you sold them times two and kept all the money. And some of the people that pay you money never see any transmitter. I will prove them, Biafra, I will prove them. Just relax. George Onyibe, you went and formed a group you call a Neoma group out from IPOB family that we are doing. Then when somebody confronted you asking you, why do you form this Anoma group not under IPOB as African rep, you told the person that Anoma is not Biafra, that it is out of Biafra, that Biafra is different and the Anoma forum is different. They are my Biafra brothers. I want you to be listening, because whatever I'm telling you now, I have evidence. But because I'm going to run this program for 2 hours, I may not be able to begin to show you all those things. But to prepare your mind, on Tuesday, I am calling on all the people that have sent money to this idiot to forward me all the information. What I did to Magnus Soraka would be a child's play to what I will do to you. George Onyibe, I have mean you, I mean Gonki, Boy Kokoko. All the transmitters you were selling, we are not accountable for. They were not accounted for. All the money that you made as African Red, all the coordinators that they were collecting money given to you, you are eating. I'm going to prove it today. George Onyibe, why did you got angry with me the day I came in Gwacha? Our leader gave me instruction as the national auditor. I was the first national auditor of this struggle. I go from state to state to do my audit, to checkmate all our coordinators that are spending our money. George Onyibe, did you or did you not tell me that before I go to any state or to go to any region, that I must first take permission from you, so that when I get there, you will give me instruction on how to operate? Did you say that or not? If you swear, you will die. You will not eat chairman food yourself, Nisi. I told you, Umar Onyibe, I am sorry. I am not reporting to you. I am not reporting to even Uchenefo. I am reporting directly to our leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. That was his instruction. I follow instruction. So how dare you ask me to come and to report to you when I am going, for example, I'm going to Uguacha to do my audit. The reason why Oyibe was asking me to report to him is because there is a sinister he's trying to cover up. There is a plan that he had with some coordinators that Oyibe want to cover up all in Biafra land and across Biafra land. Yes, I am saying it, and I'm facing the camera, and I'm not putting any eyeglass. The world is in my eyes because I'm the man that speaks the truth, and that truth that I'm speaking is what is going to set me free. George Onyibe, why were you quarreling with me that I should tell you wherever I'm going to, so that you will give me instruction and direct me and call the people I'm going to meet before? Excuse me, you are not the director general, you're not our finance officer general. You are not. Sister Nenyanya was. And the instruction given to me by Mazin Nankan did not say report to Nenyanya. Who are you? Rat like you that joined the struggle yesterday. You're a rat in the struggle. You're a novice, a wealthy man. You don't know how the foundation was built. That is why you jump on it and you make money from it. And since you begin to grow wings, those wings were cut down. Then now you are fighting. We are fighting a struggle that doesn't know how the foundation was established. Our leader told me, whatever you are doing, report to me. You, Onyibe, told me, as long as you are the African rep, as long as you are interim Nigeria coordinator, that anything that I'm doing, I must come to you first and report to you. I told you I will not do that. George Onyibe, I told you categorically no. I can never report to you. What I can do is, if I am going to Iguacha, I will tell you that I'll be going to Iguacha, not to report to you. Who are you for me to report to you? Who are you that I should report to you? Because you want to cover up all the places you have been collecting money, knowing that me, I'm a nonsense man. I'm a fearless son of a fearless father. I do not want to associate myself with cowards, with thieves, with armed robbers in the struggle. I do not want to do that. That is why I disagree to give you any detail about my movement and how I'm doing my audit. At the time you were asking me to come and tell you how I am auditing, how I said, why would I do that? You even told me that I should be giving you a copy of all my audit. I said, for what? Who are you? Copy of the audit that I am doing sent to me by Mazen Nandekano. He did not even tell me, send a copy of your audit to Nenyanya. He says to me direct, he knows why he is doing what he's doing. And when I want to travel to the north to go and do audit in the north, you had the information, you called me. I'm going to the north. I say, it's a which day? I was supposed to go to the north like tomorrow. I lied to you that I was going to go to the north next 2 days because I knew that you have a plan. I'm a mafia. Born mafia. Nobody say mafia. I went ahead of you. When you heard the information that I'm in Kano, you went mad. The same hotel where you lodged, when you visited Kano, was the same hotel where I lodged. Mandela Hotel, I mentioned the name of the hotel. Mandela Hotel, that is where I lodged when I visited Kano. The Kano's IPOB members that are watching this program will confirm what I'm saying. That is where I was lodged. They say that is where George Onyibe was lodged too. You begin to ask me, why am I always trying to do things without consulting you? Why am I always going to places without, why am I jumping your office? Which office? The office that is taking that is taking information from me. George Onyibe, have you forgotten that your office, that your African rep office, was taking information from me, from my own office? Dear friends, I'm not boasting, I'm telling you how it is. And those that know how we operate will understand what I'm saying. George Onyibe, go and do this. So, it's me that will call you to tell you, Oga say, go and do this. George Onyibe, do this. It's me that Oga will call and say, go and do this. Except some issues that Oga want to speak with you direct. Except some issues. But in terms of normal coordinating, George Onyibe, you that is asking me to report to you when you are getting information on what you should do from my office, are you mad? You were angry because you knew that I was going to uncover all your evil. Dear friends, I want you people to understand the reason why I'm giving you this preamble. You see, like a preamble. You have not heard anything yet. Do you people know that any place that George Onyebe is going, he used to give them bail, how much they are going to pay? He will choose the hotel where he's going to stay. Where he's going, he chooses how much they're going to give him. This is a freedom fighter. I don't want to mention some people's name, some coordinator's name, so that I will not implicate them. But Joe Donnie, I want you to challenge what I am saying right now on that you are lying broadcast. Please, somebody should send this to Joe Donnie. If you're his friend, I have blocked him, I have banned him. He's not. I don't befriend fools. Somebody should send it to him. I won't say what you did not do with this my mouth. I can never say what you did not do. Everything I'm going to say is what you have done. But like I said, this is just the beginning. The battle line is drawn. George Onyebe, when you want to go to Enugu, you will call the coordinator of Enugu. You tell them what you want, how much you want, the hotel you want to stay, how many days you're going to stay. They will provide it for you because you're African Red. This is a freedom fighter. George Onyebe, I want to remind you what happened when Chimobi, aka Waka Waka, was still alive. I want to remind you what happened in Enugu when Irania and Go were sacked from IPOB. And our leader was still in the prison. They wanted to scatter Enugu. They wanted to bring Enugu down. Our leader sent you to Enugu to go and look into Enugu to see what you can do there. George Onyebe, you went to Enugu. You couldn't do anything in Enugu. You could not do anything in Enugu. You could not reshuffle Enugu. You could not arrange Enugu. You could not do any shapes. Because you don't know where to start. You don't know what to do. Our leader sent me. He did not send me not only to Enugu. He sent me to Enugu. I went to Enugu. I reshuffled Enugu. He sent me to Imo. I reshuffled Imo. He sent me to Anambra. Not that I reshuffled it within my power. With the power that he invested on me, he gave me the authority, said, this. It is me that keep going from state to state, bringing all the people that our leader have given me their names. And some of them, I also recommended to the DOS that these people, when we started practicing, what they call it, solitaria coordinators, Anambra, you guys know I am saying the truth. Enugu, you guys know I'm saying the truth. Ebo, you know. Asaba, you know. The Delta, you know. Igbocha, you know. All of you knew. So because you couldn't do anything, the job that was sent to you, our leader sent me. You heard that I was sent to go to Enugu. You came with Waka Waka to that place. Nobody told me that you were coming. Because I've spent like 1 week in Enugu doing the job that I know how best to do. Some of you doesn't know what we have done in this struggle, but I don't need to make mouth. I don't need to shout. When the going was tough, when the coast was very, very difficult, when the coast was like a jungle, when people were afraid to go and talk about IPOB, that is when people like us, we are walking. Don't even, we are hiding from one place to another. You came with Waka Waka. You came and sat at the back of the seat. And I was on the high table with members of IPOB principal officers. When I cited you, you were seated beside Chimobi. Waka Waka, I cited you and said, that is George Onyebe. Because I'm a man that respects authority. I'm a man that have respect for my fellow human being. I'm a man that respects position, but I am also a man that fears no human being. I can respect your position, I can respect you, but I can never be afraid of you. I stood up and called you and said, come here, come over to this place. You said, no, 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 yeah, okay. I said, no, you came, nobody said to you, you came because you heard that I'm in Enugu. You came to observe that thing that you were sent to come and do that you couldn't do. How this guy can do it? And I brought you to the high table. I introduced you as George Onyibe. Then, African Red. Then Enugu acknowledged you. Just the same way I used to introduce you in the palace to the securities in the palace that this is George Onyibe. Then any day he come here, you guys should give him direct access. George Onyibe, in this struggle, I have played a very big role to help you do your job when you are still the George Onyibe we used to know. If you deny it, then I'll show proofs. Then when you came, you were like somebody that water swallowed because I asked you, did Oga send you? You said no. That you came on your own and said, okay, no problem. Because I knew if Oga sent you, you would have worked with me. You were not comfortable the way I was handling the meeting. At the end of the day, everything in Enugu was done beautifully, perfectly, and okay. What was your report with Waka Waka to Uchebefor? Because then Waka Waka was reporting to Uchebefor with you. Biafra so they go George Onyibe and Uchebefor, they are looking for your information. He was using Chimobi. Let Chimobi be also rest in peace. You were reporting to Uchebefor. While I was there talking, arranging things, you guys were transmitting what I was saying, recording it to Uchebefor. You thought I don't know. I knew all this. I never asked you. I never disturb you. Because our people says that he that goes to equity must go with clean hand. So what happened to you after that very day? You became jealous of me. Very, very jealous. Because I did my job, which you couldn't do. The same thing applies in Aba. You were sent to Aba to go and make peace in Aba. You went there, you messed everything up. You are not man enough, George Onyibe. You were only bribed, you're only talking, it doesn't have action. When you were called to come and settle an issue in Aba, you went there. You couldn't stand as a man to decree a word on the authority that was invested on you as African Red. You are afraid that if you do it, those people who are giving you money when you come, who used to take you to the finest hotel and buy you all the things you want and give you cash, will not do it again. Me, I'm not interested. The reason why I still remain the way I am is because I don't hope on anybody to do my job in IPOB. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is the only man that when he says go, I go. When he says stop, I stop. But all of you that are castigating Mazen Nnamdi Kanu today are depending on IPOB principal officers, on coordinators. That is why you cannot be able, when you see a coordinator doing something bad, you cannot open your mouth and say, you are doing bad, I remove you. The same thing applies in Anambra State. In Umo, when I'm talking, I will talk with evidence. In Umo, George Onyibe, you went to Umo to mess everything up in Umo. You are the reason why Anambra State is in turmoil up to today. Our leader gave instruction that a certain guy should be removed from Umo. Because the instruction was that no, there's not going to be any general coordinator in Umo. No general coordinator in Umo. That it is going to be 4 units make one zone. 4 units make one zone. Then one guy came out, Chigozu Dozo, came out and said that, you know, he's going to be the general because you know how much he's making from the whole crowd in Umo. George Onyibe, when you were sent there, what did you do? I am the last man that will go against the command of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. I don't see the way he asked me to do it. So what I'm telling you today is our people should know what you have done in this struggle that people doesn't know, that I have them in my palm. George Onyibe, you went there, you connect with Udozo. Udozo gave you money. After giving you money, you couldn't remove Udozo. You couldn't do your job well. Why? Because you have collected money, bribe. That is all you care about, to feed your family. To feed your family. You were creating, George Onyibe, you were going all about creating your own cabals within IPOB. All the whole African countries where IPOB is located, George Onyibe has some coordinators that were reporting to him. And he is reporting to Uchebefor. It's been a long time. Told Oyibe, I told you that any day you come out a little bit, I will bring you out and show you and show to the world. Jojo Nibe, your deal with the people in America, I have them in my hand. Our people in UK, I have them in my hand. With proof. Jojo Nibe, I want you to tell the world what happened to Waka Waka. Yeah, friends, I want to use this opportunity today to tell you that Waka Waka died of poison. Chimwebi was killed. Waka Waka was killed. She died by poison. I told somebody that in this struggle, the reason why I have been going forward in this struggle, the reason why I have not been, nobody can break me down in this struggle is because I don't have a permanent friend and I don't have a permanent enemy. Once you go to the wrong way, I fire you. Once you are doing good, we are friends. And I don't become my hope on anybody for survival. Jojo Nibe, you have to tell the world what happened to Waka Waka. You were the only person that knew that Waka Waka was sick. And you did not bring the news or the information to the appropriate body on time until Waka Waka was down. I am saying it on this platform. Biafra, I told you guys that this guy, Jojo Nibe, is evil. Believe me, you. I'm not saying it because he's kicking against IPOB. I'm saying it because I have a lot of information that you don't know about this evil man called Jojo Nibe. Forget about his grammar. English is not our, it's not our dialect. We are not English people. In as much as you can understand what I'm saying, that is okay for me. Those that big grammar, those that use idiom that to convince people, to make people believe them that they are formidable, they are this, all of them from A to Z are liars. People like Magnus Oraka, who is going about now begging money to feed his children. Magnus Oraka is going about today begging for money to feed his children. And who is he begging it from? From the same Igbo people that he's calling Muku. Jojo Nibe, all the money that you have made in this struggle will kill you. Those money that you have made in this struggle will kill you. Then the reason how you fought against Tony Tiger, the fact is coming out much more. I will show the world who you are, who you really are. Tuesday is coming. Like I said, whenever I bring anybody's issue on this platform, forget that person. The last thing I will do is to come and lie to you to make you believe me. But my job is for them to, my job is to expose them when they are lying. Jojo Nibe must tell us what happened to Waka Waka. Chimwebi, you must tell us what happened to that young lady that died of poison. She was poisoned. At the time, they begin to give themselves poison. At the time, they begin to I know someone, they begin to involve police to arrest some of the people that they think they may take their position. All of you, I know all your jobs in this struggle. Jojo Nibe must tell the world how he killed Waka Waka. What happened to Waka Waka? Because they were working together. Even Waka Waka had her own shortcomings because she talked too much. Waka Waka had her own shortcomings. She talked too much. And because of the way she talked, because of the way she exposed some things, people will not be relaxing watching her. My brothers and my sisters, in this struggle, there are so many evil people that you never believe that are in this struggle. So anybody that Mazin Nnamdi Kanu stand up to say, go down, I don't want you again. You people should know that that person doesn't want to be whoever she or he was claiming to be. I am not here to make it look good, though. I am not here to make it look good. I am here to tell you the way it is, raw, real, and direct. Jojo Nibe, what was your plan in Côte d'Ivoire? You wanted to remove Emeka Gift from Côte d'Ivoire so that they can control Côte d'Ivoire, Ivory Coast. You have fight with Emeka Gift up to today. Well, because Emeka Gift did not give you free landing in Cote d'Ivoire. Just like you had free landing in Cotonou. You had free landing in Ghana. You have free landing in Senegal. All these places, George Onyibe had free landing. Once George Onyibe say this is what he wants, they provide it for him. But in Ivory Coast, Emeka Gift said, no, I am the national coordinator of Ivory Coast. And I determine what happened here, not you, because you are not here. Then you begin to drag some coordinators to create your own cabals. Just with the plan of you and Uche Mefor to bring all those people, keep by the side, knowing that someday you are going to depart from IPOB, because you know 100% that you're going to leave IPOB someday. When radio station was given to you, George Onyibe, how much was given to you to rent a house and to fix your studio? Dear friends, 500,000 naira directly from the post of IPOB was given to this idiot. This is not the rentage. The rentage was done separately. This is to arrange the studio where this animal will be broadcasting from. And 500,000 was given to him. And as he collected that 500,000, he keep fingering our people in America. They keep sending him laptops. They keep sending him phones. Some keep sending him suits, shoes, expensive wristwatches, which I am not against. Because myself, IPOB have sent me, have bought me a laptop too. They have bought me a mobile phone too. So if they give him mobile phone, I am not against it. But George Onyibe will collect money for something that have been given to him by the authority of the movement, by the leadership of the movement. He will collect from London, he will collect from America, he will collect from Japan, he will collect from Malaysia, he will collect from Indonesia. Haba, you are a thief. A petty thief, that is who you are, George Onyibe. The 500,000 was given to you to equip your studio. Did you use it? George Onyibe, I'm asking you, did you use the 500,000? After sometimes you begin to ask for money again. You are all this money. Now, therefore, let me bust your head now. Do you know that we have an engineer that was building our transmitter for us? George Onyibe is the only person that Oga gave instruction and gave the order to work with this person. And this guy was building this transmitter at the rate of 150,000. Dear friends, George Onyibe was collecting 450 to 500,000 from IPOB members before you give them those. Before you give them those transmitter. 150 is the price, but George Onyibe was selling it at the cost of 450,000-500,000. Is this guy not a thief? And there are some people that paid for some transmitter that George Onyibe did not deliver. I have the chart, and I'm waiting for the voice note to be sent to me. George Onyibe, your days are numbered. One of the greatest decisions taken by IPOB leadership was to remove you and sack you as an IPOB member in Toto. One of the greatest. Before you joined the IPOB, nobody knew you. It is the Radio Biafra that brought you out. Now, the people from Anioma, all the people from Anioma, all the people from Ijo, all the people from Ishikiri, all the people from Ikore, all of them, we are contacting you, sending you money, supporting you financially. George Onyibe, if your house expires, Mazin Namdekamu will pay for your house rent. He will send you money for your house rent. He will send you money for your upkeep. He will send you money for your children's school fees. He will send you you money for everything that you need. Don't deliver. We keep going, fingering people from America to Malaysia to Indonesia to Japan to Europe to everywhere, begging them that his house rent has not been paid, and they'll be sending him money. Somebody sent you £1,000, and I'm waiting for the receipt of that £1,000. The money was sent to your wife's account. Don't you even. Somebody sent you £1,000 from UK. Only you and your wife knew about this £1,000. I am the fourth person that knew about it, apart from you and your wife and the person that sent it. And the person is contacting me now that you have started misbehaving, telling me I sent money, £4,000, to this guy when he was telling me of the problem he is facing. And it is his wife's account that I used to send the money, that I can prove it. I can send you the information. And many people have been contacting me about this Jojo Nibe issue. This is how you are going about collecting money from IPOB. Now you have the effrontery to turn back to say that IPOB is Yahoo Yahoo. Oh my God. Dear friends, between George Onibe and IPOB, based on this small information you are getting now, because this is just small to compare with the big one that you're going to hear, I want you people to tell us who is Yahoo Yahoo. George Onibe, when you went to Enugu to have meeting with Ohanaeze Ndoshi, the time that Ohanaeze Ndoshi, that our leader said, let us, they were calling our leader for peace talk. You represented our leader. Can you come out and tell the world how much he collected that nobody knew about? I want George Onibe to tell us how much was given to him through Nyanwodo on that meeting where Ifeanyi Uba, that meeting where Ifeanyi Uba, was it Ifeanyi Uba that collected our women's phone? The first one, you went to the first one, they fingered you, they gave you money. The second one, they fingered you, they gave you money. But you closed everywhere because you know that our leader will not hear that you collected money from such people and keep quiet. Onibe, you'll be wondering, how is this guy getting all this? Let me tell you. You are calling IPOB Yahoo Yahoo. Why you are the main Yahoo Yahoo? Therefore, let me tell you people the truth. Nobody has scammed IPOB more than George Onibe in this struggle. When a transmitter is built to be given to units, to be given to the coordinators for the rent of 150,000, George Onibe was collecting 450,000, 500,000 times three of the money. A very big criminal. That is who you are. I am waiting for you. I want you to call me out on your video between now and tomorrow, that is Monday. I want you to come out on your video. Tell the world that this is what presidency have done in this struggle. Talking about my personal life, you don't have any information. There is nothing that I've done that you only even know, that you can say that I've done this, I've done that. I am a man that goes to equity. So what happened is that I go with clean hand. In this struggle, I have record, 101% record. Positive. Your negative record in this struggle is staggering. But like I told my people on Tuesday, Ogadi Sharp, Ogadi Popo. But as it is now, with this fact of figures that I'm laying on the ground, it's just like a foundation before I will come and business you completely. I will come back to George Onibe. But now you guys should listen and listen good. The idiot you call Udele Chukwuka, that was deported from Turkey. I want you guys to listen and listen good now. Udele Chukwuka is from Amandoba. He was deported from Turkey because he think he was fighting IPOB. And he was supposed to land in Lagos. Uchemefo fingered the information of him landing in Lagos and thwarted it and made them to change his ticket to Abuja. Because they were afraid that if Uchemefo land, if Udelechukwuka land in Lagos, that he may not even leave the airport to his house. Men gapia, agapia poli. This is what they were believing. Nobody should call me now. It is not yet time to call this program. When it is time for me to call this program, I will announce it that I am ready to answer call. Not now. Please stop calling me for now. Then Uchemefo fingered it. It is Uchemefo that made Udele not to land in Lagos. I am saying it the first time on this program. Then, as Udele was sent to the north, there is a governor that is sponsoring Udele. I'm going to tell you people the sponsor of Udele today on this program, live, as in the heart. I tell you that as in the heart, that's how they bring and give you. As the case is hot, that is how I'm saying it. I'm not the pity for the case. I'm not the pity for the matter. And they talk the matter as the matter take be. This governor have sent money to Udele. This governor have rented a house for Udele. This governor have been paying Udele monthly dues. And, you know, promising him heaven and earth. The money he's using to buy his recharge card, the phone he's using, all the whole gadget he's using, one governor is doing that. And he is waiting to be included in the list of the people that are going to benefit from the 645 million that was mapped out by the federal government. That is the big deal that he's pursuing. Then the plan was keep talking against Mazina and the Kanu. Keep talking against IPOB, keep confusing people, keep putting this unit among them against 2023. And now, Gochan Tegekino, the governor, they say his name is Engineer Devil Umahi. Engineer Devil Umahi is the man that is behind the guy you call Udele Chukwuka. Engineer Devil Umahi is the governor that is behind Udele Chukwuka. He's the one that is paying his bills. I'm saying it loud and clear here. And they want Udele Chukwuka to recruit other people. They will be surprised how I will get all this information. They want him to recruit other people to bring all the crew, those people that have been sacked from IPOB, to put them together as a force to be fighting. They promise them they're going to open a radio station for them. You people should watch. Watch very, very, just watch before this 2021 is finished. You will hear Chukwuka speaking on a live radio station in Nigeria. Courtesy Devil Umahi, maybe because I've exposed it now, they may change the plans. You will see Chukwuka will be brought to live program on radio stations in Abuja to be speaking so that his voice will be heard wider, all in preparation of 2023 presidential election, because the Northerners have choose Devil Umahi as the next president of as next Igbo person that they will vote for as their president. And they have promised them that in as much as he is the president, that he is going to fight these people. That if the APC government or the Northerner who is the president is now fighting Mazina and the Kanu, or they are going to be brutal on them, they will say that it is the North against the South. Now that they're going to use Devil Umahi to fight, that once Devil Umahi become the president of Nigeria, which I know will not happen. Even if it at all it happened, their plan is that they're going to use their own brother to bring them down. And they are using Udele Chukwuka to gather some idiots, some animals together. Write it somewhere that Chukwuka, very soon you'll be hearing him talking on radio, I mean on live radio from Abuja. Very, very soon. When it happened, you will say that President Zelensky said this. How come? How did he get this information? Or maybe after they are done listening to this program, this broadcast, they may change their plan. And once they change their plan, I will still get the information on how the plan is going to be like. I tell you, sir, I see the hot massage they talk about. I don't die a long time ago, so I know they fear death again. He who is on the floor fears no fall. That vulture that cannot go to his village again in his life. If Chukwuka died today, Chukwuka will be buried in the north. If Chukwuka died today, his corpse will not come to Amandoba. If Udele died today, his corpse will not cross Anambra State, talkers of entering Imo State. He will be buried in the north. That is how it is, because actually the heart must they talk him. So Devil Umahi have projected him, using him, paying his house rent, dashing him money. If people watch him now, you see that he is changing clothes most more now. And they have projected him to be among the people that are going to benefit from that 600 million that was mapped to do what? To, you know, fight IPOB. The one they are calling Eziawo is among the clique. The one stupid idiot they call Okechukwu is among them. Clifford Chukwu Emeka Iranian is among them. Uchemefo is their leader. George Onyibe is among them. Don't worry, I will give people the full list. Maybe on Tuesday, I will gather the full list of these people that Umahi is preparing to use and confuse our people who are not listening to Radio Biafra, who are not listening to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. That is the reason why you guys should share this program, so that it's going to go like wildfire. Then that our people should begin to call their family to let them know what is happening on the ground. It is very, very important that our people knows what is happening on the ground. It is very, very important that our people tell their family members, because what they are preparing, their projection is against 2023, and they want to use this idiot against IPOB. They cannot do anything. No, I want you to know that these guys cannot do anything. They can only talk, they can only blab, they can only shout, they can only take money. But at the end of the day, Biafra will be restored. At the end of the day, Biafra will be restored. And when Biafra is restored, all of them, their corps will not enter Biafra land. All of them. The Biafra land will reject their corps. Biafra land will reject the corps of all the saboteurs. Those that will die in the north, their corps will not see Biafra land. So my brothers and my sisters, having said all this, I have told you why Udele is waxing, why he's shouting, why he's brabbing. It is the work of the Ebonyi State Governor, Devil Umahi, supported with other governors. On this program, as they heard Masade talking, I know they fear no man. I know they fear no animal. I know they fear no idiot. So as I talk, I'm here. As they hear them, they spread them, they share them. Share it. We must expose all of them. All of them from A to Z, we must expose them. The thing that you people doesn't know is that while you are planning your evil against Biafra, somebody among you, that the spirit of Biafra is in his heart, we keep revealing it to us. If you like, take them, go and do them, take them, go and do, give them, let them swear an oath, they will still reveal it, because that spirit is what is that is what we expose them from, exposing those idiots. So all of you that are here watching and listening should know that Devil Umahi is the biggest enemy of Biafra, and he is using Chukwuka to be attacking Mazen and the Kanu, attacking his mother. They were only trying to shake Mazen and the Kanu to see if Mazen and the Kanu will be distracted. But I thank God that people like us are here. We are clearing the small, small bushes for our leader to march freely into the big forest to cut the whole trees down. And I want to use this platform to challenge Udele. Udele Chukwuka, go to Amanduba, spend 1 week in a village and do live program. 1 week is too much. Spend 2 days in Amanduba. If you're a man, you were shouting in Turkey, they cannot do any shit. They can't do any jack. I will deal with them. I will do that. I know you are the game have stepped up. The game has stepped up because the PA to Umahi contacted you, telling you that they're going to work with you. People like Blue Jack, they are part and parcel of this evil. They are part and parcel of this evil. So all of them that are part and parcel of this evil, planning all the nonsense they are planning so that in 2023, they will deceive our people to say that the Biafra cannot come. And it's better you form a political party and this and that. That is what UCMFO want to champion for them. UCMFO want to start championing political party agenda for them. That is why he's calling his radio station human rights what nonsense. That it doesn't want violence. Who is violent? Who is killing who? Who is fighting who? Are we violent? Is IPOB violent? IPOB wasn't violent at all. IPOB was only holding flag, asking for our freedom through referendum. It is Nigeria government that is fighting IPOB, shooting IPOB, killing IPOB, kidnapping IPOB, arresting IPOB. So anybody that is coming now telling you, Wazurike is part and parcel of them all. Wazurike is part and parcel of them. Wazurike is part and parcel of them. In fact, your Gapatapata is Wazurike, followed by UTMFO. All the places that George Onibe have went and collect money, all the people that have given him money, all of them are going to report on this program as they are. My brothers and my sisters, my line is open. For today, this is all I want to give to you for now. I'm going to open this line and ask a call for only 30 minutes. Then I'll close the program. On Tuesday is when I'm coming to show you. You people know as I do now. I'll be showing you on the video. You're going to see them. Those of you that want to call, it's time to answer your call right now. Welcome to the program, as in the heart. Hello. Speak louder. I cannot hear you. Your voice is down. Your voice is very, very down. Can you speak louder? I cannot hear you. Please call me back again. Call me back. If you call us, please, before you speak to us, you tell us as in the heart. That's where you go talk. Welcome to the program, as in the heart. I can't hear you. The voice is very, very down. I can't hear you. What is the problem? I can't hear you. Hold on, please. Hold on, 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. Let me do something. Because I want the world to hear whatever you are saying. Can you speak up now? Let me hear you. Are you hearing me now? No, I'm not hearing you. Please call me back. Please call me back. Let me do something. Call me back. Hello, welcome to the program, as in the heart. Can you hear me? Brother, can you hear me? Let me do something. Hold on. Can you hear me now? Hello? I don't know what is wrong with our line this afternoon. I answer, but I'm not hearing them. Hello, welcome to the program, as it is.
Hello, hey,
I'm one name. Thank you very much. I can hear your voice right loud and clear now, and the world can hear you.
Thank you so much.
Welcome to the program, as in the heart.
As in the heart, now so I will open my mouth. Okay.
Thank you, my brother. Go ahead.
Okay. My name is Mr. Chinonso. It's in Australia now.
Okay.
Abalioma.
Abalioma, one name. Please speak English so that I can hear you. I greet you,
my brother, for the time you brought out to organize this program. And I just want to say something. What I want to say is this. I am trying to encourage our people. I am trying to tell them not to feel bad. I am trying to let them know to be strong and continue. I was so disappointed hearing about all these things that George Onyede did. I was creating out time. Sometimes I will forget about my job to listen to George Onyede. But hearing all this, I feel so disappointed. But I'm trying to encourage each and every one of us. Because what this thing that George Onyede did proved to me that Biafra will come. I look at my level of education and I keep it behind and I look towards Biafra. Because here, but then I am not complete because I sit in my room. I sit in my place. So I feel so bad. I am encouraging all of you to know that Biafra will come because of all these things. George Onyede, you see, what is it called? Luche, before doing. This will be the proof to you that Biafra will come. Then, secondly, I am encouraging everyone that is listening. knowing too well that we do not have a very good internet access in our land where we come from. You are the only person listening this morning that will be able to tell your brother in the village what is happening, because many of them do not know. So, I mean, because one other program that I listened to this morning, somebody said something like that, and it drew my attention. So, if there is any way, as you are listening this morning, you will be able to communicate to those of our brothers who is in the rural area, reach out, form your organizations, make sure that your youth organizations in your community will be strong, so that they will be able to get some of these information from some of us who are in the Western world.
Your voice is coming and going. Thank you. Your voice is coming and going. Please, let me answer someone else, because your voice is coming and is going. It's coming and is going. Welcome to the program, As in the Heart.
Yeah, my brother, good evening. As in the Heart. Now, welcome, my brother.
Thank you. Go ahead.
We talk As in the Heart here without any fear or favor.
That's correct. Go ahead.
We love you so much. Carry on with your work. I'm your brother from the good church.
Beautiful.
My name is Fine. I'm calling from Spain.
Go ahead.
My brother, even the people who don't know that, my own life, the financial stick, and the other thing, only the same people, my very, my movie will be the hunting. I'll put the word of the kind of way, no, even in an hour, and I have. I wouldn't know, I am going to know diaspora. I put a bob and I didn't know. This is one of them. Open I will be 10 days. You can recommend that. I saw Ibrahim. Open I will be ticket. In Ghana, I got it through a plan. I got the whole. I will release it. More bad, he said. I may look on. I may look at you. I'm a little. A boy, when I run the name, but I did it high in a man. I'm just going to book. I am a time that I will go and go. Maybe going about as it. I am going because of grammar. Every woman and Dana, one more. My kiss never show. We're more of now. Now that's why you're going to be a man now. I want to be ready. And you're going to call her one. Come on,
What we are fighting for is the survival of the 75 million people. So few saboteurs cannot hold us down. Never. Welcome to the program, As in the Heart. Please lower the gadget you are watching this program with. And talk to Ross direct.
As in the Heart.
As in the Heart, what thing go happen?
As in the Heart.
What thing go happen?
I'm not going to talk him.
Why you didn't wait before? You don't know, say you go talk to As in the Heart, now so you go talk him.
My brother, you know when I make you know that. My name is Chukwu Mekonya. I'm calling from Spain.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I just want to thank you, recommend you for all the good jobs you are doing, my brother. It is not easy. And little did we know that somebody like that, when you go, will be somebody that will come out this time around to declare what is involved in before. I'm very, very surprised at him. So thank God for the life of people like you that has come out boldly to expose all those people. I'm very, very grateful. I thank you for the good job you are doing.
Thank you.
Keep it up, my brother. Thank you. That's the only contribution I have this afternoon.
Thank you very much. And I like it when people make their contribution short and straight. Welcome to the program, As in the Heart. Welcome to the program, As in the Heart. are not saying anything. Call us back. You are not saying anything. Welcome to the program, Asile Hot.
Asile Hot. Why to play the card, Yama?
Why, Yama?
To be saying, I think I'm coming out.
The world is hearing your voice.
It's terrible cold now. The world, thank you very much.
The world is
hearing. Good afternoon, my lovers of freedom all over the world. Oh, the noise is too much. I don't know. The network is bad. My name is Madam Oduka. I'm calling from Spain here. Thank you so much for your great work you are doing to Libya, France. And our onion door, wherever you are, you will live long. You will live long and get your fast to us. No matter whatever they are doing, we don't care. God have already brought you to give us Biafra. Our promised land, you are going, we are getting there, and you are to be us inside. My dear, what I'm saying is that the reason why I think this call now is good. Let us know with this exposure, all of us will know who we are and the what we are with who are belonging to. No matter anything they are doing, our last onion broadcast, Biafrans all over the world, try to have your Bible and train. We know our saboteurs and we need to know them. The reason why they are destroying, what we are fighting for. We are fighting for our land. God has said this is the time we must go back to our land. Nobody can remove it. It's not a bad thing we are doing. So, what everything that is happening, we are not going to go back. Mothers, adults, our great women, try to really get in touch because this struggle now is so much that I'm still shouting it. We cannot relent or leave this aggression for every other. We mothers, we have our group in the whole world, mostly in the upper land. There is some important thing now we have to be doing to help our fathers and brothers. And we have to be meeting ourselves and connecting our people. We cannot go into the land and we are not going to be able to. Just imagine, somebody that is calling elderly people that enter the struggle in your new voice. We are collecting money. We are to fight acceptable with a lot of things. We need more exposures. I don't want to ask questions, but we feel all our nobody safety. Keeping the 15 or 5 years has known the reason why we are expecting. But the people will be at the side, destroying, that's getting. And the worst part is because of Martin and the channel. I had imagined that the kind of voice, that is the reason why I see in this trouble. Everybody that knows me, I don't like to give any group. But so far I had this at our own points. And some people by the way trying to destroy the thing. This is 2021. It's the year of that is
Thank you very much, Madam Ojukwu, for your contribution. Your voice, I begin to lose your voice. So, and I was just trying to hear you, but your voice was coming and going. Welcome to the program, Asile Hot. Welcome to the program.
Yeah, Mazi, good afternoon.
When you call me, I don't want to hear good afternoon. You call me, you tell me, hey, greet me with Asile Hot. That is what I want to hear.
Asile Hot, Mazi,
go ahead.
Mazi, listen to me, please. I'm calling from Barcelona. I'm one of the coordinators here.
Go ahead, brother.
But I'm the coordinator of Catalonia, and then a coordinator of one of the units here in Catalonia.
Okay.
I want to say something concerning this You know, while I was listening to you, you made mention about the studio that
No, it's not what I said. I said that our leader, our leader from the pocket of IPOB sent him 500,000 for the studio. Our leader paid that to him. So go ahead, okay. That's what you want to say. Yeah.
Okay. Why I'm calling just because of SM studio issue. Sometime last year, a guy came from Denmark to Spain due to one thing or the other by name Ograya Biedocha. Ograya Biedocha is a friend to Mazio Junior. So he came to Spain with the help of our European rep here in Europe. So we received him here in Catalonia.
Okay.
Then along the line, he got the issue of furnishing Mazio's studio. Because according to him, why only the broadcast and the background was always noisy. So he brought the issue, saying that if we can help him in order to follow that studio, so that the studio will be better. I called the master from the executive. What I'm saying here, Master, I am very, very serious because I am somebody under oath. I am under oath. What I say, I stand by it. And I want my lead to come out and deny what I'm saying here today.
Go ahead, my brother.
In fact, whether he comes out to deny or not, what I'm going to say, which I believe is true, is going to affect him, except if he confesses.
Okay.
So, I rallied my men, we gathered, and then we agreed that we are going to read the sum of 1,200 because that was the big zero of the gas.
Hello?
Yeah. Hello?
Your voice.
Yeah.
The last thing I heard you said was $1,200. Is it dollar, euro, or pound?
Yes.
Be specific because the word is listening.
Euro. No, I said, I'm here, I'm a coordinator on the hood.
Okay.
So I'm not going to subtract.
Okay.
So he gave us a bill, and the bill there was 1,200 euro, which we converted, and then it turned out to be 400 something thousand. So the receipts I have, because if he denies, I'm going to tender the receipts. We paid him this more 3 times.
Okay.
But I was surprised when I heard this evening that for the sake of the same studio, our leader gave him a sum of 500,000.
Yes.
Now, sometime as if I wrote him privately when I heard he was coming out to make a broadcast in media, so-called non-right radio. I warned him that he should better go into his shell and keep quiet. I thought he was intelligent. That he was going to build me. But in sense of my calling out my job, because I heard his voice while he was broadcasting, and completely what I heard this evening, that the man that our leader paid him a sum of 500,000. So, from what we have discovered, we found out that Mazemi and that so-called of Biodiocha are working together to scam their fans worldwide. They scammed us here in Catalonia.
Okay.
Which is quite unfortunate. You know, my experience so far since I joined IPOB from 2013 to 2014, it shows that a lot of things are opening up. People you trust, people you look up to as role models, suddenly they will turn to be the lions that are taking care of the sheep. It is quite unfortunate.
Yes.
It is quite unfortunate. I am disappointed in that. Even if one of the discussions we had with this guy, Mazumbe. In fact, let me say, the influence of our plan to furnish that studio was done out of love we have for Biafra. Out of love we have, in order that what we are doing in Biafra, that is, it's a kind of our own input in order to make things improve.
I understand.
Not to make things to be in order.
I know.
That was the sense of doing that. But we finally found out that what we did was wrong, because when you make you are going to help for the world to improve what is going on, and that is what is going to be around us, then it is terrible, unfortunately.
I can't go down and call my name because this thing is not what we should take lightly. Something is not stop. If not, we are not going on here. How can we be putting all our effort, our vision into hands of those who are corrupt? And this people have their country. They have the audacity to cover the people and not brokers.
Can't you tell you?
Like what you mentioned, I am disappointed and disappointed on my vision before, because let me tell you what happened some time ago here in Spain, in Victoria, during the time of it was when we had our first different genocide exhibition in the whole world. It was hosted in Victoria, Spain. During that time, Biafrans all around the world came. Ichen Nawanelewin was there, Ichenefor was there, Obi Igwin was there, likewise with Yungo and a host of others. All of them instructed to put our fields off because there was a sensitive issue that was going to be trashed. Yes. I was the first person that came out in the open to address Biafrans, what when the war was living here in Spain. How Ichen Nawanelewin was using all sorts of tricks. He was not calling me from us. No sooner had I stopped speaking than we didn't really come out. I spoke very well that what I spoke was what really happened in the whole world. But little did we know that he came here because of Mazur. In fact, the efforts in Spain rallied around each other for thinking that we are protecting him because we felt he was being intimidated by the former DOS led by Richard Nasibu. To my greatest surprise, which never had been found, really speaking of what happened at Obi, the first broadcast he did was a broadcast I consider self-interest, what affects him and not what affects their friends. That was when I became disappointed. Even though I knew right from time, from 2014, that which never was always going contrary to the inner ideology.
That's correct.
So, what I'm saying here, man, is keeping on. The point is that no matter how this will try, no matter what we do in order to deliver what we are doing, we cannot succeed because truth is constant and truth is the most ancient reality that can never grow old. No matter how you try in order to suppress the truth, it must prevail. George Williams has been exposed. I am disappointed. I know he's listening to me. If he denies, let him come out. That IPOB Catalonia never gave him the sum of 1,200 euros for the sake of his studio.
Mazza, listen. I am using this opportunity once again to call on all Biafrans worldwide. If Joma Zonibe has scammed you, if I've collected money from you for anything in Biafra land, please, I need it on my email. Send me evidence. The reason why I want to do this is because Ndiba is none of my barriers on an area. Ndiba you could see none of my barriers on Wumba or DHG. Ndiba you could see a man at Tokotanketa and Akoro, Ego Sigia or the Kanati Ambo. Because of all these proverbs in my Igbo dialect, which I may not be privileged, I want you to send me this thing to my email. My email is acidehot@gmail.com. Send it to me there. The copy of that money that was sent. Because what I'm saying here is with facts and figures. Many people have been contacting me. People sent him money from America. People sent him money from different parts of the world, from Malaysia, from Europe, all over the world. All on one purpose. Somebody sent him 1,000 pounds sterling. That person is going to send me the information in this my same email. So he has been collecting money from people on one project. Are you getting what I'm saying now? When he was arrested, the wife called me. 180,000 was sent to the wife for the upkeep of the children. After some time, she called me again. Another money was sent to her, about 200K. The third one that was sent to her, about 300K. This George Eribe have never spoken to the world that LPOB have benefited one naira from LPOB. But I'm here to expose him. So thank you very much, my brother. As they hurt, that's all they're talking for here. Send that details. That
everything. Thank you. Thank you very much. Just as I said, what I've spoken, I'm going to follow you without every receipt.
Thank you. Please, thank you very much. God bless you. You people have seen it. On this platform, we don't lie because we are under oath to speak the truth always. We are under oath to say it the way it is, irrespective of who is concerned. You see, our leader gave him money to furniture his studio. He went and collected money again, 1,200 euros, from people in Barcelona, Spain. I know that many more calls will come, people we have scammed also. Welcome to the program, as the hot.
After the hot, for talking.
Go ahead, my brother. And your name and where you're calling from. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
My brother, I need you for a good word. It's not easy. My name is my son calling from Nandi, Pakistan.
Okay, please make it snappy. Go ahead.
Okay, my brother. They are not in this sort of.
Your network is not good. Please call me back. Your network is not good because we are running out of time. We are running out of time. I cannot be taking calls that are not clear. I need a clearer call, somebody that will speak and the word will hear. If you have any evidence against Onyibe, whatever money you have collected from you, from any part of the world, please call us and bring it to me. Call us and bring it to me. A call came from UK. Let me return that call. I'm calling the person that called me from UK. Why I was answering the other call that was not okay. If you are there, you are still watching, you are still listening, pick up the call. Welcome to the program, as the call, as the hot.
I see the hot now, so I want to come.
Go ahead, my dear sister. Your name and where you're calling from.
Yeah. My name is Charity. I'm calling from London.
Okay, go ahead, my dear.
Yeah, I just want to thank you for all your whatever you are doing, everything you are doing for their fans. Mechiko Kukadoma, bless you.
Thank you.
I just want to contribute because even what you are saying, a sister from Anioma, they handled, he created the meeting, Adabia from Freedom Fighter. I play a voice recorded message from Monibe. So, it's not today he has been trying causing confusion and trying to create cabal in IPOB. But another thing I want to say is that because these people are scammers, what I want their fans to know is that because these people, they are scammers, and our leader does not want evil people or, you know, for this freedom to be something to make money. He doesn't want them to make money from it. And because of that, they are calling him a scammer. That is what people should understand. That these people that are devilish, that are evil. So every black man should not lose hope on all these issues because they're important. We have to discuss about them and we have to expose them of whom they are.
Of course.
So that we should be happy because all of them are coming out one after the other. So that is what I want to just appreciate you this evening. And just want to confirm from what you have said that Adabia for Freedom Fighter has played a recorded video of what George Onibe told them in that Anioma meeting. So I thank you very much for all your efforts. I thank you, Mechiko Kukadoma, bless you.
Yeah,
bye. Thank you.
Hold on before you go, my sister. Hold on, please. You know, our people are very stubborn people. Our people are very, very stubborn people. And our people are very intelligent people. And our people are very smart people. And most of our people are also stupid, too. They like when you tell them something, you show them. Can you please send me that voice note that you are talking about to this particular line and write, you are Adabia father call, please. this. Because on Tuesday, Gadiebu, the line is open. People are sending me a lot of
you know what I'm trying to tell you. The person I'm telling you are that Biafra from freedom fighter from Italy. He did a credit, unless you are going to talk to her to send the voicemail to you.
Please, you have my number. Give it
it's to not her. Me. Oh, and
please send it. Send my number to her. Tell her that Ma Aziobale Zetchukwu became a city hot. Biafra TV one. To play that a voice note about Onyibe and the, everything that has to do with him that she know should be brought to the should be brought to me so that I will because we need to and God bless you, dear friends. I promise you guys that I'm going to spend only about 2 hours right now. This is like ending the program by 2 hours. I feel like ending the program by 2 hours, but many people are still calling. More calls are still coming in. Please, if you call and I didn't answer your call, maybe because I was engaged. If you want to call me, you can call me again. I still have a few minutes to spend with you before I come off, before I go off the offline, you know. But I don't know how I'm going to do it because as I can, I'm still ready to call to bring in more information on this program. Dear friends, I would like to stop the program when once it is on 2 hours. So somebody called me a few minutes ago. Let me return that person's call. Let me return that person's call. We are moving forward. George Onyibe, you're a madman. You cannot just come and use IPOB to make money and come and turn against IPOB. Welcome to the program as it is hot. Can you hear me? I'm calling you and you are calling me at the same time. Let me drop so that you can call, then I'll answer you. You can't come to IPOB and use IPOB to make money. At the same time, you turn against IPOB, calling IPOB Yahoo. God will punish you. Welcome to the program, as they all.
Man, good evening.
Good evening from here.
Happy day, hot. Maze, good evening. Hey, my brother, how is everything? I'm listening to the program.
And you say, as in the hot, what is going to happen as in the hot?
Yes, Maze, as in the hot. I've listened to the program. I want you to continue on the good work you are doing. You are watching it. Elohim will guide you. And as you have followed this path of truth, everything will go well. We are praying that our leader will succeed. That's my contribution.
Thank you very much, and God bless you. Very straight to the point. You say as in the heart, but he no talk saying as so you go talk him. If you talk as in the heart, please always say it as so you go talk him. Because as in the heart is nothing but the truth. It is truth and nothing but the truth. Do not forget that our leader, Mazen Namdekanu, is going to speak to us this evening by 7 o'clock. That is 2 hours from now, and that is one of the reasons why I would like to end this program now. Dear friends, those of you that are watching, those of you that are typing, those of you that are contributing, if you want me to end the program right now, please indicate. If you want me to give more time, maybe 10 minutes for those that want to contribute, please tell, let me know. Let me see if I can extend to by 10 minutes. But for me, I'm good to go. But if you guys want me to extend this time, maybe up to 10 minutes or 15 minutes. If I read it from there, from you, I can do that. If you want me to go, please indicate. If you want me to give more time, please indicate, because we'll still have time for our leaders to come up, which is by 7 o'clock. Arm robbers, thieves, yahoos are not wanted in this struggle. All of you that comes to IPOB to make money from IPOB, then turn back against IPOB and call IPOB thieves. God will punish all of you from A to Z. Your job is to come and do that rubbish, but my job is to come and finish you all with facts and figures. You can lie, but once it comes to Biafra struggle, I don't joke with it. I will expose you to the letter. Some people say I should extend, some people say I should ride on. Some people say I should go and rest. Oh my God. As in the hot, as you can see, it is 2 hours, 2 hours, some seconds that we are running right now. And I want everybody that watch this program to share it. I want anybody that want to contribute to this program to call. And those of you that have facts and evidences on the money that this man has been collected from IPOB, please bring it forth. Please bring it forth. I have a lot already. I need more. George Onibe is a cunning man. George Onibe is a very big thief. When he's talking to you, he is recording you. When you're talking to him, he is recording you. All the discussions that George Onibe have with 99.9% of IPOBs are recorded. And I don't know why he's recording you guys. And when he's recording, when he's done recording, he will edit, remove his own side of the story, and publish only yours. But I thank God I don't have any skeleton in my cupboard. I have no skeleton in my cupboard. George Onibe, if you think I have any skeleton in my cupboard, expose me, because I'm going to expose you on Tuesday, just as I've started exposing you today. And Udele Chukwuka from Mamandoba, God has punished you already now. You are doing errand boy for Umahi. Why Umahi is doing errand boy for the Sokoto Caliphate? So you are finished. He has rented house for you, giving you money to buy data, paying you. Continue. So while you continue, just know that once you, any day you die, you are not going to come to, your dead body cannot touch Biafra land. But if you're a man, come with that, those in Damiga, those your police and the escort that they may promise you, come with them. Come with them now to your village, because what you are doing is sabotaging this struggle. What you are doing is trying to drag the struggle into the mud, but you cannot, because you are a nobody. Umahi, you can never be the president of Nigeria. Nigeria is an aspired country, and everybody will answer their father's name very, very, very soon. You will see how it's going to happen. And I want to use this opportunity to thank ESN, Eastern Security Network, all of you gallant men and women that are in the bush fighting to protect our land. May Chukwu Kamema bless all of you. May Elohim give you guys more strength, more knowledge, more wisdom and understanding, that at the end of the day, we shall restore our nation Biafra, and the name of Chukwu Kamema shall be exalted among above every other names. My brother, my sister, if you are sleeping well and waking up in the morning, don't forget to pray for Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, because the war this man is fighting is more than expectation. It's an uncountable war. He is fighting from all angles, from east, west, north, and south. Only one man fighting the enemies, fighting international communities, fighting Arab world, fighting some countries that Nigeria have brought over to fight against Biafra restoration, at the same time fighting Biafra that are fighting against him. So you have to pray for that man, because all of you that never believe that this struggle will take us to where we are today, you have seen it, that we are moving forward. And at the end of the day, the name of Chukwu Kamema shall be exalted. I remember your brother Mazo Ali Chukwu became, as we wait to listen to our leader Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, I may transmit his program on this platform. For those of you who may not be privileged to get hold of it, I may transmit it here. Don't forget that what we're using here is data. And we are targeted on every program we are doing. We know how much data we are spending, both uploading and downloading and everything. So may Chukwu Kamema bless all of you. I love you all. Wait for me on Tuesday. On Tuesday, I'm going to make that program in the evening. It's going to be from 4 o'clock till any time that everybody's tired, because I'm going to expose you to the letter. Thank you so much. And may God bless all of you. I love you all. Thank you.